It's the final match, the league stage, before the semi-finals. There's just one final slot available. Goa Pirates can seal their semi-final slot if they beat the Gujarat Warriors. For Goa, Mukesh Gora will be looking for a win against Mohammad Sorab Gancho. Mukesh Gora looked in great touch in his win against Sameer Ushay. Pooja Tomar will be looking to kickstart with a win against Tulasi Helen. The Pirates will be relying heavily on Clint Shezog, who won both his fights with aplomb. Clint will be up against the menacing Babaji Chaudhary, who brushed aside Siam Prasad. Who will win this epic battle? Lastly, Goa will be hoping for another stellar performance from rock-solid Sandeep Dhaiya, who will be locking horns with Navneet. Sandeep Dhaiya has been invincible so far. Can Goa Pirates make it to the Final Four? It's a must-win game for Goa Pirates. Can they progress, or will the Gujarat Warriors spoil their party? A battle royale on Super Sunday on the Super Fight League. Never stop fighting.
Whoa! 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 The celebrations continue. The Super Fight League. Goa Pirates versus Gujarat Warriors. Goa have to win tonight to get into the semi-finals. If they lose, they're out of the league. And we have the fans of
Goa!
We have the fans of
Gujarat!
Why do you think Goa's going to win?
Because we have a clan!
Why do you think Gujarat's going to win?
We have Babaji!
Yeah! Do you want to knock him out? Yeah, the fights are between the fans and the fights are happening in the cage. Let the war begin in the Super Fight League!
One team will be playing for pride and the other one for a place in the semi-finals. Gujarat Warriors takes on the Goa Pirates, match number 12 of Group B. This is Super Fight League. Good evening everyone and welcome to the Super Fight League. It's Super Sunday and we'll be witnessing the last of the league matches before we head towards the knockouts next weekend. It's Goa Pirates taking on the Gujarat Warriors and joining me is the two-time MMA champion, our expert and commentator, Harrison.
Oh, thank you. It's great to be back. I love being here. India is beautiful. I'm so excited for tonight.
Good to have you here as well. Well, you know, big night for Goa. And, you know, one of the most important things for a fighter is to have a clear mindset. And that's exactly the advantage that Goa has. They win and they qualify.
Goa has a very simple game plan here. They just got to go out and get the win. They don't need to win by a ton of points. What matters is the win. And if they win, tonight they jump from third place up to first place, which would put the Bengaluru Tigers down to second and the Mumbai Maniacs out of the semis.
And it won't be easy for Goa today because Gujarat is playing for pride. They could play spoilers. Two important fighters that we need to talk about is Babaji Chaudhary and Sandeep Dhaiya. Now, both these fighters have been phenomenal at Agya Padre in 2017.
Here you're going to see just the power that Babaji brings. But he's also showed his submission game. He's finished both of his opponents, one by knockout, as you see there, and one by sub. So he's got a tough opponent in Clint, who's a very accomplished grappler, got two subs. So we'll get to see what he's going to bring. And then you've got Sandeep. Look at that knockout. He just brings so much power. He's won both of his fights, one by knockout, and one when his opponent refused to continue.
Yeah. Well, both these fighters, we'll be looking at their bouts today. Let's have a look at the points table. It's rather interesting. We already had our three semi-finals, but we still do not know who's going to play who in the semi-finals. Punjab and Delhi have qualified for the semi-final stage. Haryana and UP, sadly, they are out for 2017. Group B, is where the action is going to be happening tonight. It's Bengaluru, now number one position, followed by Mumbai, Goa and Gujarat. If Goa wins tonight, they will become table toppers and knock out Mumbai. Alistair, I mean, it's another interesting table, you know. I mean, Goa in a very great position, all they're supposed to is win. But Mumbai will be watching this match very, very seriously and closely.
It's like with Haryana on Friday, they had to just sit and watch and hope that they make it in. That's where the Maniacs are at. They're not in control of their own destiny tonight.
All right, let's see who the fans are voting for on our M-Champ contest. It's the Goa Pirates versus the Gujarat Warriors. Well, 65% say Gujarat Warriors will be spoilers tonight. They will win. And 35% say Goa Pirates will win. Our winners for the previous match, Shivangi Mudgal, Hitanshi Goyal, Shakti Shukla, Sanjeev Rajput, Narsib Bhai Ratwa. Well, congratulations to you guys. Download the MChat application, participate, vote for your team, and you will win goodies from us. Let's also thank our sponsors quickly. The show is sanctioned by the All India Mixed Martial Arts Association. I'd like to thank Hero Cycles, Intex, Dijon, 8K Miles and Media, Jaldi Paisa, Jora Group, Manforce, Punjab Grill, India On Track, Quickly, Radharan Oils, UB News Media and Communication Limited, our activation partner DLF Premium Malls, 5 years sponsored by Extreme Pro Gear, hospital partner Primus Super Speciality Hospital, healthcare partner Total Health Sums, nutrition partner Bodybuilding India, ticketing partner Book My Show, On Cue Production is managing the stage. Channel partners are Sony ESPN, Sony ESPN HD, and Sony Live. Event managed by 77 Entertainment Private Limited, and live telecast produced by Sportsworks. Brilliant atmosphere in the stadium out here. It's an important encounter for Goa Pirates. Let's see how the bouts are lined up. Let's have a look at the fight card. Harrison, take us through this, please.
All right, we've got a great fight card tonight. I'm very excited for it. As you can see, Babajit Chaudhry is going to fight Clint Cizak. That is the matchup that I'm most excited for. They both got finishes in both of their fights.
And both are unbeaten as well.
Both are unbeaten. Like, it's just going to be a great matchup. And if the Gujarat Warriors are going to pull this up.
Yeah, let's not forget, he's against a new guy, Navneet Kadyan, who's fighting for the first time. So Navneet will not have it easy in his debut match at the Super Fight League.
No, not at all. And sometimes that's just the way to go. But here at Super Fight League, you got to be ready for anything. Never stop fighting.
Well, quickly, I want to ask you, actually, who do you think the Punjab will face?
Unfortunately, I got to go disagree with the fans. I think Goa's going to win it. So I think Punjab's going to be playing the Bengaluru Tigers.
All right, that's the first bout coming up for you guys. Himanshu Kaushik from Gujarat Warriors will take on Nitesh Yadav of the Goa Pirates. Jared is down there in the ozone. Take it away, Jared.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome. And now, live from Siri Ford, New Delhi, India, it's the Super Fight League! Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the cage, Himanshu Kaushik!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the SFL League Fight Nights. My name is Arjun Chumukati. I'm joined by my co-commentator, Harrison Bevins, in what is one of the last nights and one of the last fights for either Gujarat, Mumbai, or Goa. Neither of these teams can get knocked out. Gujarat is definitely out. There's no way they can come back and win. But you know what? This fight is for pride and respect.
Yeah, tonight's a big night. You've got a lot of teams that are on. If Goa can win, they're going to jump to the number one spot, knock Bengaluru down to the number two spot, and knock Mumbai out. If they lose tonight and Gujarat is able to play spoilers, they're out.
It's going to be a crazy night indeed. And Goa has to win one way or the other. Now, introducing from the Gujarat Warriors is Himanshu Kaushik. Lots of practice, lots of skills. Skilled Wushu fighters, got some great kicks, all-round game. But you know what? This is his strength. I've seen him fight earlier in the amateur league. He's got some good slick striking, comes in and out, darts in and out, and has some of those good Wushu trips as well to his game.
And he's going to need that tonight. He's got a tough opponent tonight. So he's got to use all that training, that Wushu training that he has, use those kicks, try and keep it at range, look for some push kicks, and mix up the level of those kicks. But most importantly, if he wants to be effective with those kicks, he's going to have to use his boxing, which is going to be a little bit of a change.
And his opponent making his way to the cage, Nitesh Yadav!
And representing the Goa Pirates is Nitesh Yadav, making his debut inside the Ozone tonight. For the Goa Pirates, all they need to do tonight is win. Doesn't matter how much, by how much, or what margin, they need to win. They need those 3 points to catch up and get next to Bangalore, secure that spot in the semifinals.
You're right. If they don't win tonight, they are out. They've got a good first fighter in Nitish Yadav coming out. I'm expecting a really good striking exchange, but I think he's also going to have the advantage in a takedown. And sometimes when you have two strikers, it comes down to who's able to take it to the ground and has the better ground game.
Sometimes two strikers can nullify one another with their stand-up skills. And this is the beauty of the sport. It's so well-rounded and the sport is ever-evolving. You see them everywhere in the world, and I think we're ready for a great fight tonight. That's both of us on screen, saying hi to the crowd. Look at this crowd here, it's perfect.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, here we go to the tail of the tape. The Goa Pirates, Nitish Yadav, taking on Himanshu Kaushik for the Gujarat Warriors. Both fighters weighed approximately the same weight. Both fighters have the same height and reach.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, his style mixed martial arts. He weighed in at 61 kilograms, representing the Gujarat Warriors. Give it up for Himanshu Kaushik! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, his style mixed martial arts and Muay Thai. He weighed in at 60 kilograms, representing the Goa Pirates. Give it up for Nitish Drama! Ladies and gentlemen, the action begins. The referee for the fight, Nitin Singh.
Okay, man. Follow my command all the time. When I say start, start. When I say stop, stop. Let's have clean and technical fight. Touch club, back to your corner.
Great show of respect between these fighters. Important night for Goa. We can't stress that enough. They have to get a win here.
And that's it. And starting out very strong is going to go a long way in doing that. They can get a knockout for 6 points, a sub for five, a TKO for four, a decision will get them three, and a draw will get them each one. But I'm interested in how the Gujarat Warriors are going to come out, because they've already lost two. There's no way they can get here. But they can be a pain in somebody's butt. And sometimes, when you feel bad, you just want to make other people feel bad too.
Way to put it as they get this contest ready. Nitish Yadav for the Goa Pirates in the blue. Himanshu Kaushik for the Gujarat Warriors in the white as we get this contest ready. First round, bantamweight division. Both these fighters striking. They're going to look to strike early. And for Gujarat, since they have nothing to lose here, I feel these fighters are just going to go all out. They're going to go for it and look for that win so that they come out on top.
Yeah, this is a good opportunity. They can't win, make it to the semis as a team, but this is for personal pride. This is to show that, hey, we're a team that needs to be respected.
Opening up with some flashy kicks is Yadav. Kaushik, both fighters taking their time, staying patient on the feet. Nobody wants to commit to anything yet, but I like how Yadav is constantly feinting.
Goodness, he took a kick, cut the knee right to the head, picked him up and power bombed him. Now he's just going ham on him.
Man, oh man, that was crazy. What a start to this night.
Absolutely fantastic, enjoyable way to start. And this is what you get from Super Fight League. Some of the best action in MMA.
You can see he enjoyed that. Oh, wait a minute, he's got a hold of the end.
He's looking for the armbar here. He needs to get off at an angle. But Yadav did a good job of backing off, not giving him the opportunity, and almost lands a head kick of his own.
That was pretty close. He almost got in there. And Kaushik just waved it off as if it was nothing.
That was almost something, though. He's got to be a lot more wary of those kicks, especially when breaking.
Both fighters back on their feet now. But look at this. Yadav looking for the takedown.
Yeah, but he shot from a long way away. His arms were out like a plane. It's easy to defend it that way. And as you see, he's got his back pushed to the cage.
Good reversal by Koshik. He's pinned up against the cage. Sorry, good reversal by Yadav. And now Koshik back in power. He's got double underhooks looking for that trip.
Koshik's doing a really good job of staying on him, but he's not getting head position. He keeps turning his back, and I really don't like that. That seems like a habit that you learn in practice.
Nice spinning back kick on that counter there, but yeah, you're right. I don't like that he's walking away. The minute he's trying to reset, he resets with his hands down, and that's the perfect time for a counter.
That was a really hard body kick, but Yadav was able to catch it and get the takedown, and now he's in topside control with Koshik's head against the cage. See what he can do from here.
Landing some nice elbows to the body is Yadav as the Goa Pirates crowd go crazy here.
And here he gave a lot of space coming up. Koshik has his head, but he just slips out of the back and Yadav's going to go right back to mount.
Beautiful mount, good elbows to the top. And Koshik really needs to get out of this position. He needs to defend well here or he's going to get beat up.
And again, right now he's just got that body lock. That's not going to save him from this position. It's a stall position. He needs to start moving his hips because right now he is just getting rained down on with punches and some elbows. He's got to be careful with those 12 to 6 elbows. The ref was right on it.
For a moment, it's a tricky rule, the 12 to 6 elbows, because they're illegal from 12 to 6 directly. Oh, look at this. Oh, he needs to get out of here, otherwise the referee's going to step in. Oh, and that's the end of the fight. Great job by Yadav. Got that mount position, ground and pound, big elbows. And you can see Koshik here, he's disappointed with that performance. Great job, and what a great start to this night. Yadav gets them the valuable 4 points with that TKO win.
And what an exciting way to start. We got to see the biggest slam of the show with a straight up powerbomb from professional wrestling. But Yadav was able to keep his cool, did not panic, get on top, and once he got to mount, did a great job posturing up, punches and elbows.
You can see the disappointment for Koshik. He really wanted to make his mark here, but that slam was really something. Look at that replay. He grabs him, waited, bang!
Just an impressive, precious show of leverage and strength there, and he immediately followed it up with some big shots, but he got a little bit wild. Ended up, let Yadav get back to the feet. There you see him catching the kick, getting the takedown, and he just went to work from here.
This was the beginning of the end. He started off with some elbows, but this was right at the end, Rick. Koshik had no answer to the ground and pound and was just taking unnecessary punishment. The referee came in at a timely moment, stopped the fight to avoid the fighter from any more punishment.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ref Nathan called a stop to the fight in the first round in 3 minutes and 52 seconds, declaring the winner by TKO from the Goa Pirates, Nitesh Drama Yadav! Ladies and gentlemen, the Goa Pirates are now 4 points!
What a start to this night. The Goa Pirates, Yadav scores the big win, gets 4 points for his team, and takes it ahead. Great night, and Goa needs to keep up this winning streak, as they're going to need that win here tonight.
And that was a very important win against the team started, because like we said, this is a must win. They jump to first place if they win this, which would put them up against the Delhi Heroes, and the Bengaluru Tigers would be up against the Cherry Punjab.
Here we go, Gujarat still yet to open their account, but Goa takes the lead with that TKO victory. But now, coming up next, Arun Gulia for the Goa Pirates takes on Amit Goswami from the Gujarat Warriors. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back.
Utah Pirates were raging like a bull in the Super Fight League, but one lady who's supporting Gujarat come what may is Mahima Chaudhary! Mahima, you've been rooting for Gujarat. They lost the first fight. Dil par thes pahunch rahi hai ki nahi?
Bilkul, but I think they'll fight back because I heard a lot of people roaring for them. And I'm always with the underdogs, and that's why I want Gujarat to win. Wait for the next round.
But I saw you getting very nervous when Goa was pouncing on Gujarat. You were literally biting your nails and saying, oh, ouch, ooh, ah.
Yeah, Goa's mean.
I know, man. It's a battle of the meanest people here as well. Tell me one thing. You've just gone to Ranchi now and you were telling me ki I'm going to teach you a dance step so that your team Gujarat gets inspired to win. Yeah. So what's that going to be?
It's very simple. Somebody like you who doesn't know how to dance can also pick up. It's very simple. It's like Bihu from Assam. It's just...
And yeah, thank you so much. And may your team dance to victory as well.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sid. That was always entertaining, Siddharth Karan. But now back to business. It's Arun Gulia for the Goa Pirates taking on Amit Goswami from the Gujarat Warriors.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the cage, Amit Goswami!
Welcome back to the Ozone, Amit Goswami. They call this man a killing machine because his weapons are his kicks. And he's looking to make a statement for his team tonight. He might not be going to the semis, but it's all about pride and honor right now.
And he's going to have to come out and be very aggressive with those kicks. Use that Taekwondo background he has. Keep it at range. And he is way more experienced. Even though his record is not favoring him right now in his career, he has far more experience at the pro level than his opponent will. And if he can come out and throw heavy kicks early, his opponent's a debut fighter, maybe make him a little bit timid, make him a little bit scared, so I'd like to also see him come out very aggressive.
I'd like to see the same from the veteran. He's got 10 years of experience in the national level. He's got done competition with Wushu, but this has been the time and time debate. Does that same striking ability and pedigree translate into MMA? Because this is an all-round sport.
And his opponent making his way to the cage, Gulia!
Makes his debut here tonight, Arun Gulia, coming back from a Wushu background. He's trained extensively and is real excited to be part of this tournament. And you know what? He's lucky. He's on a winning team.
And that's a real benefit. He's going to have a couple more opportunities to fight if they can win this one. But he's got to go out there and he has to get this win. I'm excited to see this again. We've got another striker versus striker battle. And you saw in the last fight, the difference was the takedown and that takedown ability. So it might come down to who's the better grappler again.
Very true, Harrison. That might be it. But Gulia is not going to want to strike with Goswami because the minute Goswami realizes that there's no threat of the takedown or the clinch, he's going to get comfortable. And he has far more experience than his opponent.
And you're absolutely right. I'd like to see Arun kind of take a second, feel it out as he's getting used to being a professional fighter, this being his debut fight. Take it a little easy.
Here we go, tail of the tape. Arun Gulia for the Pirates taking on Amit Goswami for the Warriors. Both fighters weigh approximately the same weight, slight height and reach advantage to the Warriors, Amit Goswami.
And now, introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, his style Taekwondo. He weighed in at 66.2 kilograms, representing the Gujarat Warriors, it's Amit Goswami! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, his style mixed martial arts. He weighed in at 66.3 kilograms, representing the Goa Pirates, it's Arun Gulia! Ladies and gentlemen, the referee for the fight, Prasad.
Listen to my instructions all the time. protect yourself all the time. When I say break or stop, stop the action. Now touch gloves if you like and back to your corners.
Here we go. Featherweight contest. Arun Gulia for the Goa Pirates in the blue trunks. Amit Goswami in the white for the Gujarat Warriors. And like you said, Harrison, a must win for Arun and the Goa Pirates.
They have something to fight for tonight, and that's a place in the semis. That's very important. There was a lot of pressure on Goa, where Gujarat Warriors just have a chance to go out and do whatever they feel, so it's a little bit more relaxed.
Not only do they have the pressure to win, but they have the pressure to win big, because that determines who they're going to face in the semifinals. A great start to this round. Both fighters come out swinging, and like we said, immediately to the grappling.
But he's going for a straight headlock, and that's just not going to work in MMA. You've got to at least get the arm, and even then, the head and arm is a very low percentage move. It's easy to get reversed, as you saw Amit just roll right through.
Good defense now. Back to his feet is Gulia, taking his time. Nice knees in the clinch by Goswami.
And Goswami is really trying to duck under and get around that. Looks like it might have landed a little bit low.
And he cracked him up. He might be hurt. Both fighters swinging here. But yeah, I think that hit him low and he tried to stop. Referee didn't catch that. If that cage wasn't there, he would have been tossed over easy. Oh! Big shots! Big knee! Man, these guys are swinging for the fences here. Goswami needs to get off that cage. I think that last shot backed him up there. You know what, Harrison, he might be out of it a little bit. You can see he's a little wobbly on his feet.
He might be a little hurt. He just got run straight into the cage and kind of fell over. Right now, you can see Arun looking to take his back. He's got to let go of that hand, start to turn into Arun, maybe look for a double. You don't want to reach around the leg like that. You leave that neck unprotected.
Look at this. He might be looking for the rear naked choke. He's got one hook in.
And Goswami's got to start attacking that hand just like he is, the one that's on top of the head. Very well done. It keeps Arun from being able to lock it in really tight, but he's still got to protect that chin. Keep it tucked. What I'd like to see him do is take that arm, use his left arm and overhook Arun's free hand, the one that he has control, start to turn in.
Good defensive job by Goswami, and they're back on their feet. Both of them swinging for the fences. And not a dull moment in this fight so far as he reached the halfway mark of round number one.
Arun needs to keep his hands up. He's going to get hit in the face over and over again. They're at his nipples. And when he,
big shot!
Just like that.
Oh, both of them swinging for the fences.
Forget technique. This is a fight. These two are just swinging for the fences.
It's a slugfest indeed by both these fighters. It's a battle of attrition. Who wants it more at this point?
Arun's already breathing heavy. He's using a lot of energy. And that could be a lot of being new in this. You get that adrenaline dump. It can be really hard to recover in your first fight.
Goswami's just waiting for him to come in. He's showing that big hand. And that's not the most intelligent way to fight.
He's literally just running in with his hands at his waist. And he keeps eating punches. Goswami's doing a great job of catching him coming in.
Both fighters a little sloppy, but like you said, it's not about the technique anymore. But one thing, Harrison, this sort of pace is ridiculously difficult to keep up for three rounds.
Especially if you're as tense, and you're seeing it in both fighters, as they are already looking very tired. Sometimes when you're fighting, that adrenaline kicks in, and if you don't know how to control it, you can gas out very quick.
You can see Goswami's corner yelling at him to press the action. They know his opponent is hurt. Gulia might be hurt. His hands are by his waist. And I think Goswami's just waiting for him to come in.
And Goswami needs to start using setup strikes. Right now, they're just winging everything as hard as he can. That's an exhausting way to fight. And it's giving his opponent time to catch a breather. Beautiful spinning back kick lands right on those lower ribs.
Very nicely done by Goswami. Now looking for that takedown. He's got his back. Oh, man. Big slam. Straight to ground and pound, but that will take a lot of energy to do.
And Goswami's starting to get his hooks in, but he's a little bit high. As you can see, he gets shucked off right there. He has a possibility for that schoolyard finish. Look at this. Does a great job taking his back, getting the hooks in. It's a much more secure position here.
Arun 30 seconds in the round.
Arun needs to start fighting that hand. It's hard to tell from here if that's under the chin or not.
It looks like it's under the chin. We can't. We need to get a better camera angle. It might just be, but I think Arun has to. That's why he might run out of time as Arun reverses that position with 20 seconds remaining in the round.
Arun needs to do a lot of work. I think he's losing this fight. And Goswami's locking up that triangle. He needs to start to get it a bit more of an angle, start moving to his left, or transition this to the armbar. He's got about five seconds.
He's going to run out of time, Harrison. And he has. This fight goes to round number two.
Both fighters look exhausted after a very high-intensity first round. Good job working for that triangle at the end. I just don't know that he had the strength to finish it or the time.
No, it was crazy from the get-go. Both fighters swinging for the fences, creating heavy, heavy leather. And this was the start of the fight.
And this is where you got to be careful going for that head and arm throw or just a headlock throw there. As you see, he was easily rolled.
And this was that crazy exchange against the cage. Both fights, just see the way this swinging. I don't think there's a lot of technique in there, but sure as hell a lot of power there, swinging with everything they got. And this was a slam in the end.
Good slam by Goswami, got his hips low. Here he's trying to finish that triangle. He doesn't quite have the angle. He wants to be off. When you're working at a triangle, ideally your head is gonna be at a 90 degree angle. Really help you get that leverage and angle to squeeze that tight. And I don't think he had the strength or the time. It finished the round.
He's going to find out in what shape these fighters are in round number two as we get ready. They gave it their all in round number one, and both these fighters were gassing hard. If you're just joining us, ladies and gentlemen, it's Amit Goswami for the Gujarat Warriors in the white trunks, Arun Golia in the blue for the Goa Pirates. And we cannot stress this enough, the Goa Pirates need to win.
Go Pirates really need to win tonight. This will go a long way. But Arun looks very shaky. It looks like his legs are gone. He's having trouble just taking a few steps back. But Goswami doesn't look like he has much left either.
Goswami needs to stay patient, put together a combination by showing that right hand. I think Arun sees it coming. He needs to set up that big right hand with some strikes. A jab, leg kick.
And here he comes. He's able to get the takedown. And Arun's just so tired at this point. He doesn't really seem to have much to defend.
Oh, good, he falls in a mount.
Good transition from Goswami. And he's just going to unload with punches from here.
Goswami looking to do some damage from this position.
Arun steps over that arm. Got that down. It's going to make it a little bit harder for, Goswami steps over. Then
hammer fists here.
In a modified mount. Now he's going to take the back. He's got those hooks in. He needs to get his hips up. And last time he was bucked off the top, he was too far forward. He needs to sit behind those elbows.
Waiting for his opportunity now. This cannot be easy for Arun carrying all that weight. He's already tired. He was wobbly on his feet. And now Amit Goswami is just going to wait for his chance and unload with those big shots. Here we go. Back again in mount. And ladies and gentlemen, this might be the end.
Goswami's showing a really good ability to transition from position to position without getting rolled. We've seen people get rolled from mount before, but he's took his back when Arun tried to roll right back to that modified mount. Great job staying in top position and doing damage.
I don't think Arun has enough strength remaining to reverse from this position either, because he's taking some serious punishment and the referee is really looking on. Carefully, Goswami is picking his shots.
I'd like to see some elbows from this position, but these punches seem to be doing their job.
Oh, he slipped. Oh, he lost position, and now Arun dropped. He needs to be careful of that arm.
Again, he's it. Goswami's got that triangle locked in, but he doesn't have the angle. There you see him make a readjustment. He pushes that arm across. He needs to reach up behind the head and start pulling down or start throwing some elbows from here.
So you can see he was fatigued. He took a moment, take a breather there. Now he goes at it.
But you can see from here, he needs to...
Oh, wait a minute. He tapped.
Apparently that was it. Was that verbal or? I think that might have just been being tired and in a comfortable position. Normally with the arm triangle, you need the arm across the neck, but both fighters are so tired.
That's just crazy because we didn't see a tap. We didn't see the replay again. Maybe we didn't see a tap. Maybe the referee was right on top of the action. Maybe he heard Arun. You can have a verbal submission as well.
And here we go. We've got a good.
Yeah. Oh, he tapped. It was on the other side.
Yep. Goswami did a good job locking in that triangle. What he needs to do next time to make it a little bit more sure is if he can get that arm across and really get that finish. But excellent job continuing to fight. Look for that triangle, and he notches another win.
Great job by Goswami as he puts the Gujarat Warriors on the map with 5 big points with that triangle submission finish. So the points so far are now Gujarat leading 5-4 with the 1-point difference between the two teams. This is the beauty of the sport. Somebody can be leading by 9 points and then just one knockout and you can come back in.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ref Prasad called a stop to the fight in the second round in 2 minutes and 36 seconds, declaring the winner, submission by the triangle, from the Gujarat Warriors, Amit Goswami! Ladies and gentlemen, Gujarat Warriors now stand at 5 points, while Doha are still at 4.
Great fight by Goswami, puts the Warriors on the map, gets the triangle victory and the valuable 5 points. Now we take a look at the current standings. Gujarat versus Goa, first fight, TKO win for Goa, 4 points. Second fight, submission win for Gujarat, 5-4, 1 point separating the two teams. But now up next in the women's flyweight division is Tulasi Helen for the Goa Pirates taking on Pooja Tomar for the Gujarat Warriors. Stay tuned, we'll be right back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Before we head to our next fight in the women's flyweight division, Tulasi Helen for the Goa Pirates
taking on Pooja Tomar for the Gujarat Warriors. But before that, let's just take a look at Nitesh Yadav's post-fight interview.
आपने इतना aggressive play किया था आज, जब आप आए, जब आप enter किए cage, तभी पता चल गया था, you are going to be very, very aggressive. You are not patient at all. क्या एक रणनीति थी, or was it anger against Gujarat?
Sir, ये जो fight थी, मेरे पास दोस्त जो मेरा भाई जैसा था, वो कुछ दिन पहले bike accident में मरा गया, जिसके लिए उसने मुझे बोला था कि मैं दिल्ली आऊँगा तेरा match देखने के लिए, but वो नहीं आ पाया. अफसोस, बट मैं उसका सपना साकार कर दिया. उसने बोला था भाई आज तू जीतेगा तो मैं गलियों गली में तेरे बैनर्स लगाऊंगा. आज ये फाइट उसके लिए ही है. थैंक यू.
लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एज यू सी, इट्स नॉट ओनली अ फाइट टू विन, बट इट्स अ फाइट फॉर हिज फैमिली. ही लॉस्ट हिज ब्रदर एंड ही फॉट फॉर हिज ब्रदर टुनाइट. मे हिज सोल रेस्ट इन पीस. और आपका भाई आपसे बहुत गर्व महसूस कर रहा होगा. लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, गिव इट अप फॉर नितेश.
Ladies and gentlemen, making her way to the cage, Pooja Tomar!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back Pooja Tomar, who makes her way for the Gujarat Warriors. Had a tough fight in the Ozone the last time she fought, but tonight she wants to change all of that as she takes on Tulasi Helen.
I really like Pooja and what she brings. She's got a lot of experience, but she's trained in both karate and taekwondo. The movement styles of both of those are different. So if she's able to combine those, she can really finish the fight on the feet. But she's also been training her Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. So we'll see what she's able to do if it does go to the ground.
As we've seen an indicator tonight, when there are two similar styles, two strikers, the fights have all finished on the ground. Tulasi, great striker, good movement. Maybe we'll see this fight go to the ground.
And as Tomar is more of a kicker and really builds around that, you got to be careful. When you have a kick-heavy offense, it's a little easier to get a takedown when you can catch a kick because you're on one foot, you're a little off balance. And if her opponent can blow through, we might have to see what she can do off her back.
And her opponent making her way to the cage, Tulasi Helen!
In her last fight, she took on Hannah Kamp. Didn't get too much time to step in and use her striking. But one thing we saw in those brief moments before she got taken down and submitted, she was looked slick on her feet.
Landed a really nice push kick on Hannah, actually knocked Hannah down with that. Be interesting to see what she can do from here. Just continue to use that striking. She went up against a very experienced ground fighter in Hannah, and this time she's probably going to have a little bit more of a chance to work her offense. But she needs to work behind setup strikes. We're seeing a lot of fighters come in, just throw haymakers, and that's how they close the distance. Work behind that jab. Work behind a jab-cross combination. A one jab-cross right kick. Those are the things that set up your power punches.
If there ever was a favorable matchup tonight, Tulasi Helen might get a chance to shine. She's got some excellent boxing skills, and we're going to go see that tonight. But first, to tail the tape, Goa Pirates Tulasi Helen takes on Pooja Tomar from the Gujarat Warriors. Tulasi weighed in slightly heavier than her opponent, and both fighters have similar height and reach.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, her style, Wushu. She weighed in at 54 kilograms, representing the Gujarat Warriors. It's Pooja Tomar! And her opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, her style, mixed martial arts. She weighed in at 55.7 kilograms, representing the Goa Pirates, it's Tulasi Helen! Ladies and gentlemen, as the action begins, a referee for the fight, Nathan Singh.
Ladies, obey my command all the time. When I say start, start. When I say stop, stop. Touch gloves and back to your corner.
Great show of sportsmanship, always. That's what the Super Fight League is about. It's business once that cage door shuts. But before and after, there's always great sportsmanship.
And as a fighter, you know what you have to go through to get ready for a fight. You know your opponent's gone through the same thing. A lot of respect before. Once that fight starts, it's going to be all business, but I can guarantee you, you're going to see respect after this fight, no matter how it ends.
Oh, absolutely. I couldn't agree more. As we get ready for round number one, no touch of gloves as Helen comes into range. You can see immediately Tomar shows her Taekwondo background, opens up with a nice head kick. And look at Helen just move. She's bouncing side to side. She's already getting comfortable and she's waiting for Pooja to step in. Oh, there you go.
And Pooja's being very smart. She's not buying into it. Helen's trying to bait her in, hands down, and look to counter. I'd like to see Tomar try and start working behind that jab, close that distance. And that's when you can look. Helen's throwing big strikes, and you can see she's getting off balance.
Pooja landed a nice jab there before Helen missed with that straight cross. But you can see she's waiting for her to come in and look in the counter. That's 1-2. Oh, she slipped. Oh, wow, that may cost her.
She did a really good job of getting her base under her, getting back to her feet. She got this head and arm position. Good job pummeling back in, trying to create some space for the striking.
Pushes her off. There's Helen. There was a slip there a moment ago, ladies and gentlemen. She'll be looking for something. You can see her breathing heavily. A minute. Pooja looked to grapple, and that should be Pooja's strategy here. You can see Helen in the first fight, she got submitted by Hannah easily, and Pooja probably saw those tapes and is looking to do the same.
And I'd like to see Pooja, she's just moving forward, use that lateral movement. As Helen tries to circle around you, move left and right and put her back to the cage. Control the distance that way.
I don't know what Helen is expecting of Pooja, because she's standing right in front of her. She's trying to get her to bait her to come in, and then is moving away. She's looking for, oh, nice counter there. That's exactly what Pooja should not be looking to do. She's playing Helen's game right now.
Yeah, she needs to take her time, work behind that jab, and punch to the body. Throw a couple of jabs or straight crosses to the body. Take the wind out a little bit. Those hurt. Those will make you change your game. Plus, when you throw into the body, you're changing levels, so you're...
You get your head up that center line.
And you drop down a little bit, so even the hooks aren't going to land.
Very nice combination there. Right hand to the jaw and a body kick to follow up with it. I'd like to see more of the kicks coming from Pooja. And like you said, Harrison, the body is a bigger target than the head, so attacking the body is a lot easier.
And Pooja needs to start moving left to right. You see, when you just move forward on a circling opponent, Helen is able to circle forever, and you're never going to corner it. That's what you need, that circling movement, left to right, back Helen up to the cage, and that's where you can start working. Right now, Pooja's just moving forward.
No, but I like what Pooja's doing. She may not be cutting off the cage, but she's not chasing her either. She's leading with that front leg that's giving her enough space to come back and recover. Great takedown by Pooja.
That's a good, very good point. She was being patient. Once she closed the distance there, she saw her opportunity. She might have an opportunity to set up that arm bar. She can harvest that arm, get an angle. Might be hard with the cage there.
This is a very awkward position. But this is what I mean. Tulasi is not well-versed on the ground. She's in a great position. Nice shot to the body. Pooja has to be careful not to brawl with Helen here.
I really like what I'm seeing from Pooja. She's being patient, she's taking her time, she's working behind her strike, and she's not rushing anything. What I would like to see are some jabs to the body.
I certainly seen a difference from her last fight. She's staying way more patient, calculated, and not rushing into her opponent or trying to beat her opponent's game plan at her own game. Tulasi has one plan. She's waiting for her. Sorry, Tulasi has one plan. She's waiting for Pooja to come in and counter with that big right.
And Pooja can do a lot to help stop that if she starts throwing some feints. You're seeing a little, there you go, like that. Get your opponent guessing, and sometimes they'll tell you how they're going to respond so you can plan accordingly.
I like how she's faking that jab and coming over with the body kick. She threw a couple of kicks down the middle to the body, which landed. There you go, once more. Oh, nice big right hand. Good combination to finish up.
Pooja's doing a great job of taking her time, working forward. I like the feints. A great way to fight a counter fighter is to counter their counter. Throw some feints, get them to respond, and then when they're off balance and out of position, score your point.
10 seconds remaining in this round, and I would say Pooja's fought the smartest fight. Helen's strategy is not working out for her so far as we get ready for round number two.
No, Helen's clearly waiting for Pooja to rush in and try and catch, as you said, with that straight right, that overhand, and some hooks. And Pooja's doing a really good job of taking her time. She won that round. She won that round pretty handily. She controlled where the fight took place. She was pressing forward. She landed the better strikes. Helen needs to start pushing that action a little bit more.
Definitely. You can see the replay here. She faked the takedown. That was a slip, but she fell down. Pooja controlled her briefly, got that clinch position, but you can see she did not like it. Here, Pooja got the takedown, was in an awkward position. Helen eventually got out of it, and the fighters reset on their feet. Pooja landed the better combinations overall. Look at that, body kick up the middle, right hand, finished up with that leg kick to the body combination, and that was the story of round number one.
I really like the combinations that Pooja is throwing. That is the key, and that's something that we haven't seen a lot of this tournament, are good combinations. When you're only throwing one strike, if that doesn't land, you have no options. If you can follow up a couple of punches with a head kick like you saw, or a body kick, those are going to score points when your opponent thinks that it's over.
Get ready for round number two. The crowd is electric here inside the Surrey Fort Stadium. Helen versus Pooja for what was a great round number one, a good technical battle, and for once, Pooja showing real restraint, not falling into her opponent's game plan, not looking to brawl with her, which isn't her strength. She needs to stay technical, stay on the outside, and if she can keep this up for the next two rounds, she's going to take home that win.
And Pooja's corner was saying, throw that inside leg kick and immediately follow it up with the opposite side straight. So that'd be a left leg kick followed by a right straight. It's a good way, especially if you're fighting a counter fighter. Sometimes they'll move right into that jab.
Good job. I like how she's mixing it up. The minute she throws one of the counters, beautifully done. Lovely. Right hook, body kick. Right hook, body kick. And Helen right now is getting frustrated.
Helen's got to be careful. She's circling right into Pooja's power. And when you're fighting somebody the opposite stance, now Pooja switches back. When you're fighting somebody the opposite stance, the first battle you got to win is you got to keep your lead foot outside of theirs. That gives you the angle. It puts you off at the side, just like Helen's doing here.
Pooja needs to be a little careful here. She's had great success with that right. That come exactly. The right hook over the top, body kick. And what Helen needs to do here is circle to her opposite side, away from that left kick.
Excellent side kicks to help keep that distance as Helen's trying to engage, and they are in a bit of a brawl right now.
Very nice hip toss.
Really nice hip toss there. She's got position, but she has to make sure she doesn't get, she's already transitioned to a half guard, an open half guard, straight into mouth.
Oh, huge shot. Big grounded pound. This fight is over. Oh, it's over. Pooja Tomar fought the perfect fight here tonight. Great ground and pound, took her opponent down, and outstruck the boxing champion.
As far as seeing a game plan be stuck to in the cage and worked, and you see that efficiency, this might be the best that we've seen of the entire tournament. She did a great job keeping it technical, not engaging in brawls. As soon as it got to the ground, here you see some brutal ground and pound, oh, and the man. Ref had seen enough.
This was the end of the fight. She took her down. Effortlessly passed guard, got in the mount, position, bang, big punches, big power, and that's all Helen could take. You can see Helen in the corner there, she's protesting with her teammates, said she wasn't out of it, but you know what, that was a great stoppage.
Yeah, it was a fight of safety always come first. It's frustrating when you think you're still fine. The ref made his decision, and what's most important is that the fighter's safety.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ref Nitin call a stop to this fight in the second round in 1 minute and 32 seconds, declaring the winner by TKO from the Gujarat Warriors, Pooja Tomar! Ladies and gentlemen, Gujarat Warriors are now 9 points!
What a beautiful performance by Pooja Tomar. She fought the perfect fight. From the get-go, round number one, didn't fall into her opponent's game plan, did not fight her game, and comes away with a big TKO win. Gujarat now lead 9-4 with a 5-point difference.
Goa has a lot of work to do.
Here we go, but up next, a crackerjack of a fight. Mukesh Gora for the Pirates takes on Mohammad Saurabh for the Gujarat Warriors. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
Whoa! Gujarat Warriors, guns blazing, 9-4 in their favor. We've got celebrity artist Rubal Nagi and of course celebrity chef Amrita Raichand. You are supporting Gujarat, you are supporting Goa. You must be a very happy lady.
Very happy. I just saw the fight and I think it was just amazing. And to see girls do this, it just makes me super happy.
And what about you, Amrita?
Well, I'm supporting Goa and I'm a little nervous right now. My brother is a part of Goa, so I'm here to cheer him and the team. I'm sure they'll buck up and they're going to fight back.
But you know what? Since you're in opposite teams, what about a face-off between you two girls, man? Come on, punch them. Whoa.
I only fight with my knives. I don't have my knives there, so I'm not going to fight.
She's so dangerous, man. Whoa.
Thanks, Sid. But now all back to business, because coming up next is Mukesh Gora, the knockout artist for the Goa Pirates, taking on Mohammad Saurabh for the Gujarat Warriors.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mohammad Saurabh!
Mohammad Saurabh making his way to the Ozone for the first time, representing the Gujarat Warriors. And this kid has had 7 years of MMA experience. He's been training everything from the ground game to stand-up, jiu-jitsu, and you know, that is a really good thing because the new breed is evolving, has evolved in every aspect of the sport.
And that's exactly it. If you're a striker, as Muhammad comes in initially for the striking background, you got to be able to learn the ground also, because at some point you're going to be on the ground. And if he does get taken down, what I'd like to see him do, start pushing away on the head, try and get back to his feet, or if he's up against the cage, use that cage. That cage can be your friend, but it can also be your enemy. So if you're up against there, make sure you use it to your advantage. Start wall walking with your shoulders, work back to your feet.
You've seen some veteran strikers over the years in multiple organizations who are striking first fighters and have learned one key aspect. If you're good at one aspect of MMA, you got to learn the other just so that you can get back to your power position.
And his opponent making his way to the cage, Mukesh Gora!
One of the oldest veterans in the Super Fight League makes his way for the Goa Pirates, who now need a must win because they are down 9-4. They've lost their last two fights and they certainly need a big TKO KO here.
But if Gora can follow up his last, or in this fight, do what he did last fight, great display of kicks, work the body a lot with lightning fast kicks, which set up that head kick finish. Absolutely savage knockout. Right, put that shin right across the chin, battered his opponent. That's what he's going to need to do, get those 6 points.
Here we go, Mukesh Gora taking on Mohammad Sohrab in the tail of the tape. Both fighters made in approximately the same weight, same height and reach for either fighter. Now let's take a look at the points table in Group A. You know, Punjab and Delhi have both qualified, but with just 1 point difference, 40-39 and 37-36, it was that close.
And here we see what we've got going on tonight. If Goa can win, they're going to jump to the top spot, push Bengaluru down to second and Mumbai out. If they lose tonight, they are out of the semi. So it's either first or nothing.
That's how crucial this fight is.
And now, introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, his style mixed martial arts. He weighed in at 71 kilograms, representing Gujarat Warriors. Give it up for Mohammad Sohrab Janjo! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, his style wushu. He weighed in at 71 kilograms, representing the Goa Pirates. It's Mukesh Gora! Ladies and gentlemen, as the action begins, the referee for the fight, Alan Fernandez.
All right, guys, we've been through the rules in the dressing room. Any questions? If you want, touch gloves now and step back to your corner.
Both fighters touch gloves. If you're just joining us, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to start this exciting contest. Sohrab Ganjo in the white trunks representing the Gujarat Warriors and the veteran striker Mukesh Gora in the blue.
And Sohrab really needs to be careful of those kicks. We got to see just how devastating they can be. And they're so quick. What I'd like to see him do is, when those kicks come in, immediately close the distance. When you're fighting against a kicker like that, if you can work inside and make the fight close, you really nullify a lot of those kicks.
Now, you're going to see that on display in his last fight. There was no wind up to those kicks, and they came quick. You're just waiting for those right now. But you can see Ganjo probably did his homework. He's prepared. Coming, he's a striker first as well. Wow. He needs to be careful and keeps his hands up. And Gora's going to look to land those to the body.
And he needs to close the, either block them and close the distance, or close the distance immediately after, but coming in with his hands up.
Ow! Big shot. He needs to be careful here. He got cracked with that right hand and body kick.
Gora's doing a much better job of adding strikes, especially behind those kicks. They can keep an opponent from coming in.
Oh man, he's hurt. He might be in trouble here. He needs to get out of there. He's wincing. He might have been poked in the eye by mistake. and the action continues. I like that combination that Gora throws, comes over, follows up with the, oh, he's hurt, his eyes cut open. Might have got busted up with one of those punches or kicks. And Gora's doing such a good job of mixing up punches and kicks.
This kid needs to get off the cage.
And Sarab has no idea what's coming at him.
You know what, he might be overwhelmed. This is his first fight in the Super Fight League against a strong, tough opponent in Gora. And the crowd is chanting his name, they're going insane.
Front kick, head kick, body kick, combination, big shots. And what you're seeing from Gora that you're not seeing from a lot of the other Wushu-based fighters is he's following up his kicks with punches. He's mixing them up, and he's really confusing Muhammad. I don't think that he knows quite what to do. He's walking down, but every time Gora starts throwing him, he has no answers.
No, Muhammad is certainly a tough kid. Oh, big right hand! Took that straight on the chin. Body kick, another body kick, big liver kick, big head kick. Wow! This is insane! Big head kick. This is getting brutal quickly. Big shots. Muhammad is in big, deep trouble. This kid has a chin on him. I'll give him that. Head kick, right hand, head kick. Gora's wondering what it's going to take to knock this kid down. Wow.
Gora really put a lot into those combinations. Hopefully he didn't tire himself out too much. Kicks are a very tiring strike to throw. I'd love to see a Gora start attacking the body a little bit.
You can see Gora. You might be absolutely right, partner, because you can see Gora moving away and shaking it off. He might have put everything into those combinations there.
And sometimes when you're fighting a striker who's really good at combinations, it becomes a matter of attrition. Can you take the lumps early and slow him down? But you're starting to see some redness on Sarab's left side.
Big head kick, front, comes over. Man, it's just a moment of time with this kid. Knees, big knees, hurts into the body. Oh, look at that, Muhammad coming back. He needs to be careful here, nice shot. Oh, big right hand.
I am loving what I'm seeing from Gora here. I'm not sure what Muhammad is looking at. He needs to be paying attention to his opponent.
You don't know exactly what he said to the referee.
When you're in a fight, you gotta be able to keep your ears open and listen to your coaches without looking at them, or be able to communicate without taking your eyes off your opponent.
I think he meant that the blood might be seeping into his eye. But he's got to wait till the end of the round, or maybe the referee might be looking to step in at a dull moment. But right now, Gora is giving him no room. Head kick, big shot. Oh, another head kick. This kid might be too tough for his own good.
Yeah, Muhammad's face is all lumped up. He's cut on the left side, his right eye's swelling.
Beautiful jab. Oh man, you can see that. He's busted up bad, left and right. You can see his right eye is closing.
But he's not going anywhere. He's still standing in the pocket, which might not be the best decision, but he's shown a tremendous amount of heart. That can be very frustrating, especially with all the wonderful combinations and clean shots that Gora has been able to land.
This fight has been all Gora. He's landed a shot, but this kid is just coming forward. And you know what? I think he was pointing to his right eye. It's swelling shut, but I think he might have time. 30 seconds remaining in this round, unless Gora turns on the action. But this kid, Muhammad, is already impressing me with his ability to just step forward and take that punishment.
And the ability to take a punch is a great trait to have, but it's not something you want to become known for. So I'd like to see him get a little bit busier.
15 seconds remaining in this round, and Muhammad's face tells the story of round number one, because he has taken a beating and keeps coming forward. Nice kick, got the kick. Oh, he needs to be careful there. He almost...
Really good, an amazing round from Mukesh Gora. Muhammad's face is all battered up. That right eye is really swelling bad. Wow. He's got a cut over the left. But most importantly, he's still here. I like how he's pushing the action. He's not giving Gora time to move around and get comfortable, but he sustained a lot of damage in that.
Yeah, you know what? This is the tale of the fight. It started off with Gora, all Gora. Body kicks, head kicks, straight punches. He tagged them all around. I've never seen Gora hit someone so cleanly and stand in the pocket and keep coming forward. Look at that, the replays. It was all Gora in the shot. I think Muhammad may have gotten maybe one or two punches off. You can see the impact of the shot, and this was the end of the fight.
Gujarat caught the kick, and the ref is waving it off. The doctor has seen enough. That right eye is swelling really bad. He's got a cut over the left.
We need to confirm with, Alan, the referee has just said, he waves his hand, he's just looked at us, he can't see out of his right eye, and the fight is over. We need to check what the points are. We need to check what the points are right now, because if this is a forfeit, because if this is a forfeit, that means 6 points. Ladies and gentlemen, we've just been confirmed from the referee that it's going to be a doctor's stoppage. And Harrison, that is how many points?
That's going to be 4 points, and that's because the ref decided he was not fit to keep on fighting. He took a lot of damage.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, while we wait for the results, we'll be right back in a few moments.
Ladies and gentlemen, ref Alan Fernandez called a stop to the fight before this round to start of round two, declaring the winner by TKO due to medical injury from the Goa Pirates, Mukesh Gora! Ladies and gentlemen, the Goa Pirates are now 8 points, while the Gujarat Warriors are 9 points.
Gora! आप आए, आप कंटिन्यूसली अटैक कर रहे थे, पर आपको बोलना पड़ेगा कि सौरभ आपके सामने टिका रहा, उसकी आंख पे कट आई, वो देख नहीं पाया, तब भी वो खड़ा रहा।
मैं नॉकआउट करना चाहता था उसको, हमारे टीम को 2 पॉइंट का नुकसान हो गया, वो नॉकआउट नहीं हुआ, क्योंकि थोड़ा वार्म में बाहर आते टाइम लग जाता है, इसलिए वो नॉकआउट नहीं हो पाया, वॉर्म नहीं थी मेरी बॉडी।
आप इतने अग्रेसिव थे, जब मैं आपको बाहर देखता हूं आप शांत स्वभाव के रहते हैं, इतना अग्रेशन था, लग रहा था कि आपने ठान ली थी कि मैं टीकेओ करके रहूंगा।
सर मैं बाहर कूल माइंड रहता हूं, अंदर दिमाग पूरा सेट करके खेलता हूं, मैं टीके नहीं कर, मैं था नॉकआउट करने में था, लेकिन वो नॉकआउट से बच गया।
Nevertheless, all the best and I love the fire in Gora!
That was a great fight and I think the doctor made the right choice. He stopped the fight.
a doctor's stoppage is 4 points, and right now look how close it is to the wire, Harrison.
It's gonna come down to it. There are only two fights left and only 1 point separating them.
But up next, it's Clinton Czok for the Goa Pirates taking on the juggernaut Babaji Chaudhary for the Gujarat Warriors.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the cage, Babaji Chaudhary!
A man who needs no introduction, one of the hardest hitters in this division in the Super Fight League. Babaji Chaudhary, the captain. You know what, Harrison, he knows his team is not going to qualify, but I bet top dollar that he's going to make sure that his team wins here tonight.
This is an important fight, and he's the perfect fighter for Gujarat to have here. He's got great striking, got that knockout power. With two fights left, with only one, with Gujarat in the lead by 1 point, if he can get a knockout victory here, that will knock Goa out of the playoffs, period. Because there is no way that Goa would be able to get a 7 point to get that draw, any of that. He has to, if he can get the knockout tonight, that'll be 6 big points and really just lock it down for the Gujarat Warriors.
And his opponent making his way to the cage, Clint Czok!
His opponent, Clint Czok, has a tall task in front of him and is now at a dangerous position. If Goa at this point lose by KO or submission, they are out.
And that's very true, because even if they get a draw, it's not going to be enough points to bump them up.
It's close. He's a great grappler. In his last two fights, he's finished off on the ground with rear naked chokes. He's going to look to bull rush Babaji. He's got to close that distance. And he knows Babaji is a tough, strong, heavy, heavy kicker, heavy strikes. And he needs to close that distance ASAP.
And Babaji has shown his technical ability on the ground, getting an armbar in his first fight. But I think Clint is going to be the much more experienced grappler. And if he can wait out that early action, try and get a submission in the second or third.
Here we go. Clinton Czok for the Goa Pirates takes on Babaji Chaudhary for the Gujarat Warriors. Both fighters weigh in approximately the same weight, same height and reach advantage for either fighter.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, his style mixed martial arts. He weighed in at 77.3 kilograms, representing the Gujarat Warriors, it's Babaji Chaudhary! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, his style mixed martial arts and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. He weighed in at 77.8 kilograms, representing the Goa Pirates, it's Clint the Helicopter Czok! Ladies and gentlemen, the action begins. The referee for the fight, Alan Fernandez.
All right, guys, you've been through the rules in the dressing room. Any questions? If you want, touch gloves now and step back to your corner.
Was intense, and it's intense indeed because of how much this fight weighs right now. A win, must win for Goa.
Obviously, what's best is if Clint can come out and get the win, but if he loses by decision or TKO, they've got Sandeep Dahiya in the wings, who is definitely on point for a knockout, could catch it up. So a lot can happen in this fight. How this fight ends will decide everything for Goa.
There we go. Clint in the... Oh, he got tagged early and he pushes him off. Big kick. Babaji tricks a great takedown defense. Clint looking for that double hard.
And sometimes when you're looking for that takedown, you know you're just going to have to eat a strike or two. And that's exactly what Clint did. But he stayed in. He was able to suck that leg out. He's got to start protecting his head. but he is on top, and now it's his time to get to work.
Good job by Clint so far. Took the couple of strikes from Babajit, ate a good body kick and right hand, and now he's in half guard.
And Clint is right in his corner. He's got his longtime coach, Dennis Hallman, talking to him, so a name that's very familiar. Looking for a guillotine right here.
Oh, look at this. He got up. Babajit gets out of the way. He needs to get his leg out, hammering him with hammer fists. Clint is surviving the storm, but he can't eat too many of these. Man, look at him. Tenacious on the ground is Clint. Looking for that back now.
Very aggressive attack. He knows what he needs to do, and that's to get it on the ground. He doesn't want to stay on the feet with Babajit. But Babajit is so strong. You saw him just easily sweep Clint there. But Clint throws his hands up, shows a sign that he's good. Let's see what Babajit can do from working inside Clint's guard.
It's just the pure strength of Babajit that got him back into the guard of Clint. But Clint is dangerous from this guard. Clint's going to be throwing up, looking for submissions.
Clint's looking for, exactly, he's looking to control that wrist. There's that triangle. He needs to get a little bit more of an angle to start to get Babajit's right.
Oh, he's tapping!
That's it!
Wow! Whoa! Oh, my goodness! Man, oh, man!
Excellent job by Clint, once again, just showing that technical dominance can overcome pure strength. Babajit showing incredible class. But Clint just put his team up by 3 points.
That's a correction, Harrison. That's a submission. Babajit tapped. 5 points for Clint.
Right, but they're going to be up by three because they were down one.
Oh, I'm so sorry, mate. We need to check the record here. Look at that replay. Clint got that perfect technique, and Babajit had no option but to tap.
Really nicely done by Clint. He weathered the early storm, took some early shots. Once Babajit got back to the feet, he stayed on looking for that, looking for the takedown, even though eating a lot of big shots. And you see, locks in the Clint, and Babajit knows he got caught.
What a great fight as we wait for the results.
Ladies and gentlemen, ref Alan Fernandez called a stop to the fight in the first round in 1 minute and 41 seconds, declaring the winner submission by the triangle. From the Goa Pirates, Clint the Helicopter Caesar! Ladies and gentlemen, the Goa Pirates are now 13 points!
What?
You know, this is the spirit of the Super Fight League. Two fighters at each other, but later on, lots of respect. Clint, you are the favorite. Both of you at each other. Did you feel that this fight got over too soon for you?
Man, Babajit hits really hard. He knocks everybody out. I wanted to come down, put him on his butt as quick as possible, and finish him. I want to learn stand up from this guy. I'm excited to talk to him now throughout the rest of the tournament. This goes to all my friends and family back at home in the US, my mom and dad, and everybody in Yale, Washington.
And you know, Babajit, I have to ask you. Dono ek dusre pe haavi ho rahe the, but aake aapko laga fight itni jaldi khatam ho jayegi?
No, no. Mere ko to nahi laga tha ki fight itna jaldi khatam hoga. Actually, kya hai? Thoda maine mentally thoda preparation kam tha yaar. Waise to main sahi tha abhi fight ke liye ready tha. Pata nahi. Try karunga next time. Ye mera to last fight hai, nahi aur bahut fight karna hai.
इन्होंने एक सवाल कहा था, एक जवाब बोला था, वो ये है कि वो आपसे मूव सीखना चाहते हैं, इतनी कदर करते हैं ये आपकी।
हाँ ठीक है, इसका बीजेपी अच्छा है, ग्राउंड की व्यवस्था है, वो मैं भी इससे सीखना चाहता हूँ, सेम बात है कि मेरा स्टैंड अप ठीक है, तो ये सीखना चाहता है। थैंक यू।
What a great fight and great show of sportsmanship between both these veteran fighters. And look at the scoreboard, Harrison. Goa finally lead.
And it's a correction on my part. I said 3 points. Clint just gave his team a 4-point win or lead. That means that Sandeep can lose a decision and Goa will still move on.
And now the big one. Sandeep Dahiya from the Goa Pirates taking on Navneet Kazian from the Gujarat Warriors. Stay tuned, someone's gonna get knocked out. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back, the big one. Sandeep Dahiya for the Goa Pirates, taking on Navneet Kadian for the Gujarat Warriors.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Navneet Kadian!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. This is the big one and the decider, whether Goa moves on to the semis or does Gujarat end this dream. Navneet Kadian, representing the Warriors, has a tough task on his hands tonight as he takes on Sandeep Dahiya.
Especially when you're making your pro debut. Things change when you turn pro, so you're starting to make money. And that changes the way you train. It can also make you a little bit more anxious as you move up. But he's a good striker. He was left and his right, but when he does, he came back, because we saw what happened there in Sunday. First fight, and he's got to keep his hand high.
But this is the trouble with Sandeep. Sandeep breaks everything he touches, so that job is easier said than done. And he's got a tall task. Can he derail Goa's plans for the semi-finals?
And his opponent making his way to the cage, Sandeep Dahiya!
And here comes Sandeep. We have seen him. He's won both his fights. First by huge knockout, and the second one was when he beat Amit Thapa, when Amit Thapa could not answer the bell after the first round and retired. We've seen his knockout power. He is a savage and a brutal opening debut fight for Kadian.
He's a veteran fighter with some heavy, heavy hands. He's mixing up his game now. In his last two fights, he saw him throw kicks. He saw him knees, elbows. He's becoming a very well-rounded fighter and has got a heavy top game. He can finish the fight on the ground. He can finish on the feet. And this is very crucial for him to win here.
He's a very strong guy, but he's also shown that he can get taken down. So if he wants to have a shot to win this, he needs to make sure it stays on the feet where he can use his heavy hand and try and get the knockout. And in this fight, what's important, he can even lose by decision and Goa will still move on. He cannot afford to lose by TKO, sub, or KO.
Here we go, Sandeep Dahiya for the Goa Pirates taking on Navneet Kadian for the Gujarat Warriors. Both fighters weighed in approximately the same weight. Slight height and reach advantage to the debutant, Navneet Kadian.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, his style mixed martial arts. He weighed in at 91.6 kilograms, representing the Gujarat Warriors, it's Navneet Kadian! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, his style mixed martial arts. He weighed in at 91.9 kilograms, representing the Goa Pirates, it's Sandeep Dahiya! Ladies and gentlemen, as the action begins, a referee for the fight, Alan Fernandez.
आप दोनों को रूल्स ड्रेसिंग रूम में बताएंगे कुछ सवाल अगर आपको चाहिए ग्लव्स टच कीजिए कॉर्नर में जाइए
Here we go Dahiya in the blue trunks Navneet in the white trunks and I love the light heavyweight fights none of them have ended apart from you know a retirement in the corner none of them have ended in a decision or a submission
Yeah it's a very violent sport there was one submission at the beginning of the show But these are heavy-handed men, and it does not go to a decision. You're absolutely right. And with a guy like Sandeep throwing bombs, I don't think it's going to last long, especially considering Navneet needs a finish, needs a sub or a KO.
You never know. This is the sport of MMA. Sandeep coming in, but Navneet looks a little stiff with his striking. Dahiya is just going to look to time him with that big power left.
But I do like how he's coming in with straight kicks. It's a good way to stop an opponent from coming in. keep him at range, and you land a couple of push kicks to the solar plexus, to the belly, and it'll slow him down. It makes him start to think. And most importantly, I like that he's circling with his hands up.
Nice counter right by Sandeep as Cadian was coming in.
And Sandeep's doing a good job of being patient. He's not in a rush to brawl early because his game plan is the knockout. And sometimes that takes time, especially when you start to figure out your opponent's timing. What he has to avoid is the wrestling. He's been taken down in both of his fights.
You can see a strength advantage for Sandeep as he ragdolls his opponent.
He's doing a good job of getting his hips away, sprawling, getting his hips to the floor, clearing those legs. And now he might have a shot at a guillotine. It's going to be hard to finish from here, but he transitions it straight to mount.
Oh, I think he made a mistake, a critical error there by looking for the early finish. And he's given up position as Navneet is in his guard. Let's see what Navneet can do from this position, because this is certainly a safer place for him.
And this is where Navneet is going to probably have his most success. Although here you see Sandeep looking for that omoplata. Might be able to use it to sweep. He doesn't have control of the hand, so he's not going to be able to finish it from here.
Does he need to hold on to the left arm and push down on the back?
He needs to be able to sit his hips up, get his shoulders up off the mat, sit forward, and really be able to get that hand behind the back.
I don't think he has a position. I think he needs to take his right hand and cradle his back and simultaneously push down on the top.
Or he could just let go of it and take Yadvin's back.
Man, look at the way he's cranking his arm though.
Now he's got a chance to finish it. And he's going to...
Oh, shots to the back of the head there. Referee goes on top of it. He needs to be careful. Referee admonishes him for that. Minute and a half remaining in the round. He might be looking for the rear naked choke.
He's looking for a straight armbar here. It's going to be a tough position to finish that from. For those of you at home, just so you're aware, a back of the head, as long as your fist is making contact with the ear, it'll be considered legal. As soon as your hand does not make contact with the ear, it's considered back of the head. Just to clear that up for anybody watching at home.
Now big ground and pound by Cadian, who's got an opportunity to do some damage of his own.
And this is exactly what he needs. If he can get a TKO right here, he's going to not go out of the final.
Oh man, this is a bad position for him, because Cadian has now got plenty of time in the round. He's got almost 2 minutes, and he's in mount.
And Sanjeet's got to be careful about that left arm of his. It looks like Navneet is trying to isolate that. Maybe look for maybe a wrist lock. It's kind of hard to tell. Maybe start to harvest that arm through, look for his arm bar.
He might be looking to roll for an arm here. But oh man, that was the power of Sandeep for that reversal.
And when you feel yourself start to roll, you gotta be willing to give up the position and hold that you have so you can stay on top, especially when you got somebody as big and dangerous as Sandeep on his back. That's where you want to keep him. That's where you can do your best work.
But you know what? This is going to be interesting now, because we've got a minute left in this round. If Sandeep cannot stop him in this round, he's expending a lot of energy. And in this division, these boys are heavy. They're carrying a lot of muscle, and they are more prone to gassing than the lighter divisions. Big hammer fist by Sandeep. But good defense by... Oh, he needs to be careful there. Was that a knee to a downed opponent?
Looks like it might have been the shoulder. The ref had a good view. We couldn't really tell, but the fight is going on. Sandeep is getting busy with those shots.
Big shots. And look at this. He might be looking to take his back here.
He's got to be careful trying to jump to the back, especially when you're on the head like that. You'll fall right off.
And
they're back to the feet. Navneet did a good job of keeping it tight in the clinch, but it looks like he might be tired too.
Oh, he's gassed. You can see that the way he's looking for that takedown. And Sandeep, certainly the pressure of the two fighters. But this kid is putting on a fight in his debut. He's not betting. 10 seconds to go in round number one. I think he's going to survive. He needs to keep busy. Otherwise, Sandeep is just going to pound him.
Oh. And that's going to be a good round for both men. Navneet was able to get it to the ground and do some good work. He looks very tired. Sandeep is also tired. He's breathing heavy. Both these guys, very good first round. Very hard to score. I think I would give that to Sandeep. But Navneet did a good job when he was on top working.
It was a back and forth round. You can see here the start. Sandeep was there, but you can see Navneet got top position as well. Sandeep tried a couple of submissions at the bottom, almost had that omoplata. Reverse, landed some good ground and pound. So basically pure on damage, I would give it to Sandeep. But you never know how the judges score these fights.
And here you just see it's the end of the round, working some the body a little bit. But Sanjeet looks definitely the fresher of the two. Sorry, Sandeep.
Navneet though is putting on one heck of a fight.
And you can see Hallman saying, work that body, go for those body shots. And when you punch as hard as Sandeep does, you can do a lot of damage. If you catch somebody straight in the solar plexus or in the belly, start to work that liver. Even if you catch one of those floating ribs, one good body shot can end a fight.
Here we go, round number two. As we get ready, some water spillage there, quickly cleaned up by the corner. Referee Allen on top of the action as we get ready for round number two. Both fighters immediately, you can see Sandeep breathing heavy.
Navneet coming out with a nice left, right hand, right hook.
Oh, he's got to be careful here because Sandeep is looking to wing that left hand. But both these fighters are slugging and it's going to be night-night for anyone. Oh, nice right hand. Navneet coming over the top. Man, Sandeep could be gassed.
Sandeep,
big shot.
Good sprawl here by Sandeep. Get out position.
The referee admonishing him for shots to the back of the head again. Referee on top of the action.
Sandeep's going to get a point taken away soon right here if he keeps working the back of the head like that. Ref giving him warning, but he's got to be careful. It's his responsibility to make contact with the side of the head.
He's getting beat up here on the ground. Oh, and the fighter, oh, it's called off. Sandeep has done it.
And that is going to put Goa through to the semifinal. Sandeep came through when he needed to. He came up big. He got the TKO stoppage. Navneet was just not moving, was not improving his position and continuing to take big shots.
I think it was a function of Navneet being gassed. Both these fighters were tired, but Sandeep dug deeper, came through. It's that veteran experience that got him out of this mess. And now he comes through for the Goa Pirates as they advance.
This was a great learning experience for Navneet. He landed some good punches on the feet, did some good work on top, but Sandeep is just too strong.
Great fight, and Navneet showed some great heart in this fight. Certainly for his debut, he's done a great job against a veteran. Beautiful fight, and you know what? Goa's made it through.
Goa has made it through with that win. Excellent job, Sandeep came through when he needed to.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ref Alan Fernandez put a stop to the fight in the second round in 51 seconds, declaring the winner by TKO from the Goa Pirates, Sandeep Dahiya! Ladies and gentlemen, the Goa win this contest with 17 points!
Sandeep, what a fight, Sandeep. Congratulations, aap log semi-finals pahunch chuke hain. You were very, very tough on Navneet. You were hitting him hard.
Yeah, tha bhai. Jaise iska the first fight jeeta budhi. Iske sabse acha game iska. Ye pehla samandha jisne mere sath do round khele hain. Ab tak ka mera record फर्स्ट राउंड में फाइट कर लेता है ये बंदा अच्छा प्लेयर आने वाले टाइम में बेस्ट है
आइए खुशखबरी ये है दोस्तों संदीप बिकेम अ फादर दो दिन पहले इनका बच्चा हुआ है तो बच्चे की खुशी में मुझे लगता है कि आपने अपने बच्चे को ये फाइट गिफ्ट किया है
बच्चा छोटे बच्चे हर किसी के लक्के होते हैं मेरे लिए भी लकी है मेरा बच्चा तो आया अभी 8 तारीख को उसका जन्म हुआ है और अभी ये उसके लिए गिफ्ट है ये उसके लिए और अभी हम लीग जीत तो दिए उसके लिए या भाई हम सब के लिए गोल्डन गिफ्ट होगा
उसके नाम कुछ रखा कि नहीं
अभी रखेंगे फुर्सत से क्या भाई भाग गया बाप
देखिए दिस इज अ विक्ट्री व्हिच ही इज डेडिकेटिंग टू हिज चाइल्ड बॉर्न 2 डेज बैक एंड वी आल्सो वांट टू से अ बिग थैंक यू टू प्रमोद शर्मा ऑफ द गोवा पायरेट्स गोवा आर इन टू द सेमीफाइनल्स.
That was an amazing fight, night of fights, amazing performance on Goa, back and forth action, and that is the final tally. Goa has done it, 17-9, it was a close contest, and it was epic. Goa makes it in the semi-finals, and now we have a real fight on our hands. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back after this quick break.
Whoa, it's Goa Pirates all the way in the Super Fight League. I've got the visionary, the man behind the league, Bill Dosanjh. Bill, this is getting historic. You know, you must be so proud of everyone.
Absolutely. I mean, to be honest, it's been crazy. Even to the last second, you did not know who was going through. You know, if Gujarat came on top, they would have won. Goa would have been out. You know, it was 13-8 going into the last fight. And so now, by doing that, they've secured a top position in Group B. So Bangalore comes second. And so now, they will play... So Bangalore will play Punjab, the winners. And obviously Delhi will play the winners of Group B, which is be Goa versus Delhi in the first semi-final. And then it'll be obviously Punjab versus Bangalore. And even in Group A, if you looked at it, the point difference was the same. The points, they both won two matches each, and it went down to how many points overall that they scored. So it's been edge of the seat. You just don't know what was going to happen, you know. And even today, we had Kashir today, obviously Punjab team coach, and he did not know who he was going to play in the semi-finals, you know. So even the Bangalore went through, the Tigers, but they didn't know what position they were going to end up in. So look, it's been amazing. I mean, you've had edge of the seat to its highest level, you know, and it's only getting stronger. We got a full house every day. We turned away 400 people. I think we have to put a screen outside now for some of the audience. So it's, you know, it's amazing, and it's just growing and growing. And I want to thank all my franchisees who kind of believed in the vision from day one, all my sponsors, you know. And at the end of the day, we've got semi-finals left, we've got the finals, we've got a third, fourth place, and I've just had my daughters here as well.
You know what, you girls are enjoying the fight?
Yeah.
You're rooting for the girls?
Yes.
Whoa, do I see you in the cage very soon fighting as well?
Yes.
You know, Bill, I'm seeing fans actually loving the fighters as heroes. People are shouting, Gora, Gora. They're shouting, Clint. That means there's a massive following which is happening amongst the fans now.
Yeah, of course. I mean, look, at the end of the day, the art is to build stars, you know, and that's what we're doing. We're building stars here. You had Mukesh Gora, a back-to-back win knockout. You had Clint here, who actually really kind of sealed it for them. And then, you know, and look at Tulsi versus Pooja tomorrow. You know, these girls were so composed. The way they fought was unbelievable, you know. And at the end of the day, look, it went down again to the last fight. This is what makes what we've done here. We've created history in the sport of MMA, which is the fastest growing sport in the world. We are creating history, you know, and around the globe, people are watching. This is a new format in the world of MMA, you know. So at the end, it's only going to get better, stronger. And at the end, we're here to stay, you know. We're going to create history.
You know, you've done a lethal combination. You've got the best of fighters. You've got the big names from Bollywood coming and being intensely involved. We had Tiger doing stunts here, supporting you on social media. You've got the corporate giants as well. It is actually a synergy of corporate, Bollywood, the fans and fighters.
What more you want? We have got everything. I mean, if you add all of our celebrity co-owners who actually own, it's a total of over 100 million people that we're reaching out to, you know. And at the end of the day, Jacqueline was supposed to be here today. She's not here today, but she'll definitely be here for next week for supporting her team, you know. So at the end of the day, look, Tiger's been overwhelmingly supportive. Randeep Poda, you've seen his videos. You've seen Arjun Rampal here last night. You know, we've had them all. So at the end, it was a shame that Ajay Devgan's team, obviously Mumbai, went out. Even till tonight, they were in. You know, he must be sitting there thinking, Gujarat, go. You know, so he could be here next week, but obviously that hasn't happened. So, but obviously I'm sure Mumbai will come back stronger next year. But at the end, look, it's sports at its highest level, you know, so.
You know, we've got a big thing which is happening as well. The emotional connect. You know, one of the fighters lost his brother and he fought for his brother. You had another fighter who actually had a child 2 days back and he's saying, I'm fighting for my child. So it's fights, but with a lot of emotional cord as well.
Yeah, of course. I mean, look, at the end of the day, these guys, you know, what they go through when they train, you know, it's, they go through, I mean, you cannot imagine how deadly they're devoted to their training. And at the end, obviously, today, obviously, he's fighting for his brother. You know, it means a lot. And obviously, on the other hand, you had Sandeep, which obviously he's had a new son, you know. Look, at the end of the day, these athletes, they know they're here to make a name for themselves and actually create history for themselves, you know, at the end of the day. And we're going to give these athletes a huge platform moving forward. And at the end, at the gyms is a huge part of this, you know, where these guys from now, fans that are watching, you know, they'd be actually training these guys in gyms, you know. So look, we have a great plan, you know. At the end, it's just the beginning, and we're gonna bring some amazing stuff.
Bill, thank you so much for everything, and thank you for being you. And ladies, whoa, Karan, I'm fighting these girls and I'm gonna lose because they're stronger than I am. What's happening on the top?
Well, what's happening, Siddharth, is that we have our 4 semi-finalists for 2017 Super Fight League. Let's have a look at the points table, how the teams are lined up. The Punjab team and the Delhi team from Group A have qualified for the semi-finals. We were in search for our 4th semi-finalist from Group B, and we have that. Goa Pirates have topped the table with this emphatic victory over Gujarat Warriors. And number 2 position, we have Bengaluru Tigers. Mumbai, sadly, they have been knocked out of 2017 season, and they'll have to come back. And, well, Gujarat, it's been a rather sad season for them. Could not register a single win. They played very well today, showed a lot of promise, but couldn't do much. In the end, Goa Pirates emerging victorious. And with me in the studio right now is Cash the Flash, the coach of Sher-e Punjab. And well, could have been tricky there if Babaji could have won his fight.
What an exciting night.
Yeah.
Goa really went for it tonight, you know, and I thought Goa went in as the favourites. And they're really operating, had a good strong team. And obviously, they deserved it tonight. Well done, Goa.
Absolutely. Just tell me, you know, Sandeep Dahiya, he's been the star player for the Super Fight League. Not lost a single bout. He's won all his matches.
Well, it's good to have the confidence. And as they win, it gives them more confidence going through to the next fight. And when the fighter gets in the cage, it's all about the confidence. So that's what we're trying to do with the Punjab team. Obviously, we had a bit of a losing streak on Friday. We rested some of our players, but you better watch out for the Punjab.
He's just become a father 48 hours back. And do you think he's going to lose his edge in his fighting technique now that he's become a father? Slightly sensitive he's going to become?
Well, everyone's different. And it depends how it affects them. It can affect the training, but it can make them better as well. I think to myself, I got a child now. I'm ready for it. I'm really going to start working hard and make a living out of fighting. So it can work in the favor as well.
Well, let's have a look at the Sandeep Dahiya fight, the third fight that he fought today. It was, again, a victory for him. Well, there you go, Cash. Why don't you take us through this fight?
Yeah, that was fantastic. He went down a few times, and he regained the composure, and he was on top. And obviously, the pounding on top, it was just too much for his opponent. As you can see there, he's right on top of him. He's got complete control. Obviously, he had his downside as well, but he regained control, he got his composure back. At one time, I thought he was going to run, and he started running out of stamina, but obviously, he was wrong.
A great fighter, Sandeep Dahiya, there we are. But, he led the... let's talk about the sponsors, actually. No, it's time to thank our sponsors. That's what I've been told. They're the guys who are getting the money in for us. The show is sanctioned by the All India Mixed Martial Arts Association. We would also like to thank Hero Cycles, Intex, Bijon, 8K Miles in Media, Jaldi Paisa, Jora Group, Punjab Grill, Manforce, India On Track, Clickly, Gajaran Oils, UV News Media and Communication Limited. Activation partner is DLF Premier Malls, 5-year sponsor Extreme Pro Gear, hospital partner Primer Super Speciality Hospital, healthcare partner Total Health Sums, nutrition partner is Bodybuilding India. Book My Show is our ticketing partner, stage management by OnQ Productions. Channel partners are Sony ESPN, Sony ESPN HD, Sony Live. Event managed by 77 Entertainment Private Limited. And the live telecast is produced by Spokeworks. Well, Cash, we have a 4 semi-finalists and the lineup is here. It's going to be the Sher-e Punjab versus the Bengaluru Tigers. And the Delhi team will take on the Goa Pirates. Now, would you have preferred a certain opponent or are you happy with the lineup?
Well, as a semi-final, you can't tell who we're going to get. But I said to the team, the Punjab team, said, listen, it's a semi-final. It doesn't matter who we draw. Every team is now going to be tough. We're going to make sure the Punjab are right in the mind. We're ready for fit. All the lads are looking forward to the semi-final. And obviously, it's all about winning. Deco, Punjab, Chak Ne Fatte.
Any fighters you'll be relying on, any particular fighter that you would say would stand out in the semi-final would raise his hand up?
We've got Kantaraj.
Yeah.
Kantaraj is our captain of Gassa. You watch out for him. We got Patrick Benson, fantastic on the ground, fantastic striker. And we got one of our heavyweights, we're not sure who we're going to pick yet. We've got a choice of two. So at the moment, we've got Asha Rocker as well, who's rocking everybody.
Absolutely.
You've got to watch for Asha. She's dangerous, one of the best ladies I've seen on the tournament.
Yes, she sure is. Well, thank you so much for talking to us, Cash. All the best for the next weekend. It's time to say goodbye now. We'll be taking a break for the next 4 days. But as always, we'll be back next Friday, Saturday. It's the knockout stage time. The two semi-finals will be played on Friday and Saturday. Well, till then, very good night and goodbye from all of us out here at Super Fight League.
Thank you.
Wow, punch kick, wow. Drop him to the mat with the bishu now. Super Fight League. Cause it's in his blood. Fight, I gotta fight in the ring in the mud. Fight, I gotta fight for the opportunity to defeat the fear, fight to victory. Fight, I gotta raise his hand. Fight, I gotta take a chance. Fight, I gotta be made of adrenaline. Fight, I gotta win. Fight, I gotta win. Fight, I gotta win. Super Fight.